Welcome to Inside Japan. Hey everybody, thanks for joining us. Japan is often home to some unique eating experiences. We'll be taking a look at some of them today. Pringles is currently running a cross-promotion with a Japanese noodle company. This year, Pringles is celebrating 50 years of fun. Acecook is celebrating its 30th anniversary. To commemorate this occasion, Pringles is offering two noodle-flavored products, and Acecook is selling two Pringles-flavored noodle dishes. The first flavor Pringles is using is based on a cup ramen. While most ramen dishes have a soup base made from boiled pork parts, this ramen dish has a chicken base. To the Western diner, it may remind you of chicken noodle soup. The second flavor is Squid Yakisoba, which is a seafood noodle dish with no soup and a savory brown sauce. This is an instant noodle version of a grilled noodle dish often found at festivals. To complement these limited release potato chips, Acecook has taken the classic sour cream and onion flavor and has used it to make a unique yakisoba dish. They are also making an instant noodle dish based on Pringles jalapeño and onion flavor. Now let's take a look at how these match the original, match our expectations, and see how they stack up. Before reviewing how well the flavors were translated into chips, we thought it worth noting that Japanese Pringles are smaller and thicker, which makes the taste of the chip itself more prominent, whereas the original American chips are thinner, making the flavor easier to notice. On to the results. The chicken broth noodles and squid yakisoba flavors were well represented in chip form. And while the tastes were novel, they weren't anything to write home about, so we feel there's no need to seek these out. Before this event, we had never tried the jalapeño and onion flavored Pringles. Both the chips and the ramen were decent, but nothing earth-shattering. As for sour cream and onion, it's my go-to Pringles flavor, so I like it a lot. That being said, the thought of sour cream and onion noodles didn't sound very enticing. But in the end, we were pleasantly surprised at how much we enjoyed them. They tasted very smooth and creamy, kind of a little bit like fettuccine alfredo. And we feel they were the best of the bunch. So, to sum up, the chips were decent but unremarkable. The noodle dishes were surprisingly good and notable for making something work that really shouldn't have. So please check them out if you have the chance. As always, thank you for joining us. If you have any questions, please feel a comment below, and thanks for watching.